I'm out here with the Cleveland Clinic, and this is very interesting because a lot of kids don't get their regular eye exams. And what's great is that this basically mobile device goes to schools. So we have Heather Cimino, who's an optometrist, and Rhonda Wilson, who's going to kind of explain how this works. And it's amazing how many schools and school districts that you guys go to.
So yes, we are in 5 school districts. We examine pre-K, kindergarten, and first K students. We're in 84 schools. We're in Cleveland Heights, East Cleveland, Lakewood, Warrensville, Maple Heights.
Wow.
Am I missing anything, Dr. Cimino? And Cleveland Metropolitan Schools.
So how did this come about? You just thought these kids are not receiving their eye exams properly?
Well, Dr. Elias Trabosi, years ago, 23 years ago, said, "Hey, Rhonda, I'm thinking about a program. Let's write a grant. I want to see kids with amblyopia." And we went from there. And this is year 23, and it's been going well.
And she just mentioned that, and that's a lazy eye for that term. So talk about that and how important is it in the most common, I guess, vision problems in kids.
Well, if you think about how much learning happens in the grades that we see, in the ages that we see, ages 4 to 8, there's a lot of things that we need to use our eyes for. So if a child has one eye that's not working as well as the other one, they're not going to know it. So they're not going to sit next to their friend in class and go, "Oh, you can see well out of both of those eyes."
Yeah. And sometimes they don't tell their parents till later, going, "I can't see the board. That's why I'm not getting good grades."
And at
weeks
these ages,
and months will go by,
they're not even looking at the board.
Sure.
So we get to those ages that are older, and then they'll come home and say, "Oh, I have to squint to see."
Yeah.
We want to catch them before that becomes a problem.
And talk about how to spot problems for parents that need to be aware.
Well, to be honest, there's nothing that replaces bringing them to the eye doctor.
Yeah.
They're not going to come in saying, "Oh, I think my child has one eye that works better than the other." They'll come in if they think they're holding things too close, if they're looking too close to the TV, if they are squinting, but we want to catch the things that they don't know about, that they don't bring them in for.
So Rhonda, take us through this mobile device, which is really truly amazing that you guys can drive all these schools. It's basically, it looks just like the size of the office that I go
to.
You're
right. There's 2 exam rooms. We pull up to the school. We have permission slips prior to when we're getting there.
Okay.
We normally see approximately about 50 students a day. If a student fails the eye exam, they get a complete dilated eye exam with one of the optometrists that works here on the van.
Yeah.
If they need glasses, they pick out a free pair of glasses.
I assume.
And so we try to
have the glasses here.
We try to empower the students. So we ask them, "What's your favorite color?" The boys will say red, blue, and we pick out a couple pair of glasses that we think that looks good on them.
How sweet.
And then we give them a mirror. So, and we say, "Hey, you picked out these glasses. Look how cool. So when we see you next time, we want to see you in your glasses."
That's right. And talk about vision screening and the difference between that and comprehensive eye exam, Heather.
So vision screening is a really broad term. So at the pediatrician, a lot of times it's just visual acuity. Read the chart. Sometimes they'll do color vision. Sometimes they'll check depth perception. But our screening portion of our exam is a little more in depth. We're checking eye muscles, we're checking pupils, we check everyone for stereopsis, which is depth perception. We check reading and distance vision.
Mm-hmm.
And then if they have any red flags or failures there, we do the full eye exam.
And look at this, they even have the eye exam on the wall. I mean, it truly
cartoons.
Have everything.
Right.
So how can they access these free exams? Because I think Rhonda had mentioned earlier, these kids have to have permission slips to do this.
Yeah, so the school nurse or the staff at the school send them out well before we come in.
Okay.
So if that does come home, sign it, fill it out, get it back as soon as possible, and we can see anybody with the signed permission
slip. And the ages again?
It's pre-K, age 4 through first grade.
Okay, so we'll put all this information on our website, foxaid.com. We promise we'll link it all, but what a wonderful benefit to these kids. So Rhonda, please tell everybody thank you. I think that's awesome because parents don't have time to run errands, and again, they don't know.
Yeah.
So if you think maybe your child is struggling, sign them up and they'll be in your parking lot. All right, Rhonda and Heather, thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right, all the best.
Thank you so much.
And I need her glasses. Y'all both look cute. All right, we're gonna toss things to break. We'll be right back.